Okay, for form HTML, I am giving title as a form. You want suppose admission form. Admission form. So title is given as admission form. So I am saving this. So if suppose I am refreshing it, so it will show you admission form. Now, in admission form, which are the various things we have to enter? That is nothing but the name of the student, surname of the student, middle name, birth, date of birth, male or female category, and many other things. So that we will write one by one. So in a form, so you have to use the form tag or form tag, and in between the form tag, you can write the various fields or various other tags for the requirement of the data entry. I will explain this later, what is the class, action and method. I will explain this later, so I will remove it first. First of all, the student should have the name. So first is student name. So I will have that. Label. Student name. And for data entry, you must have the checkbox, it is the text field, so that I will have the input tag. Input tag, type is text, name and value I will explain it later. Then I will have the break. Then after student name, suppose student surname, label, student surname. And I will use again input tag and type is text. So I will save and I will compile it. See, student name, and here you can enter the data. Student surname, you can enter the data. So student name and student surname, the two fields I have. After that, suppose you have to submit this data. At least we have started with the name and surname, and you have to submit with the submit the data, so that you can use the tag as an input tag. Once again, input tag, where the type is submit. So you can have, and name is equal to submit. See, this is nothing but a submit button. This is nothing but submit button, but the text is not displayed on this button. So if you want to display the text, you have to have the value. Suppose click me. So value is click me. See this. Value comes as a click me. So if suppose I am writing the data and I am submitting click me, so it will submit the data. So basically, the form should be clearly understood, because there are many attributes in the form. First of all, I have used input type as a text. So where you can enter the text? Name means it is nothing but a variable assigned to that text. Variable. So student name, what is the name variable? I will have the S name as a variable assigned for the student name or student name. And value means the display. It is the enter name here. So what is the change you will find? So very carefully, see this, student name, enter name here. If you click on this, it will be removed, or it will be removed, and you can enter the data in this field. Correct? So means value means what to write somewhere. Suppose Gmail, enter mail here, like this. This value comes in that field. So likewise, it has that value. But if you refresh it, you have to remove all those values one by one. But sometime, wherever we are using Gmail, once we have clicked it, we can enter the data. Correct? We can enter the data. So for that purpose, instead of value, you can use placeholder. you can use placeholder, and I will show you what is the change of the placeholder. See this, as I have used the placeholder, the text becomes somewhat lesser bright, or it is faint. And if you click here, and if you enter, no need to remove whole things, yes or no? So that is the only change with the value and the placeholder. So placeholder will give you that you can enter the data directly. So those are nothing but the attributes. See, in input, this is nothing but a tag. Type is nothing but the first attribute. So type means which type? It may be text, it may be radio button, it may be checkbox, it may be Gmail. So those are nothing but the types. Then name means it is nothing but the variable name, variable assigned. Placeholder means at that place you can display the data, but which is faint, it will be displayed as a faint, and no need to remove it. If you are using value, the value you have to remove it completely. So that is only the change. Similarly, I will write for this one surname. So SS name. Remember, the variables should be meaningful. Otherwise, you cannot remember that variables. Why? I am telling because you are accessing your data through the server, and those variables are taking your data from the web page to the server and server to the web page. And because of that, this variable should be carefully designed or carefully written. Instead of value, I am suppose writing placeholder. So placeholder is surname. Now next is input type submit. Submit is different type of input or this one. Then submit value as a click me. Now understood the basic things. Input we will discuss few more later. That at least remember the input text, we have used the input type as a text, then it is as a submit. So you can do this